85th minute, a quite superb solo effort in which Mariner used speed and strength before finding the bottom corner of the Leeds net. So it was 1-0 to Ipswich at half-time, but 4 minutes into the second half, the scores were level. Leeds worked a nice move which ended with Alan Curtis's cross being met by Ray Hankin and knocked into the path of Trevor Cherry. But the question Ipswich were asking is, did Cherry handle before scoring? Anyway, 1-1 it was, and there was no question that Paul Mariner definitely handled shortly afterwards when he again had a goal disallowed. Ironically, it was yet another handball, this time by Ipswich defender Alan Hunter, which settled the issue. Because from the resulting penalty kick, Kevin Hurd scored to give a final scoreline of Leeds United 2, Ipswich Town 1. The defeat for Leeds led to a demonstration by about 250 fans chanting Adamson out. But Leeds manager Jimmy Adamson said they're entitled to shout, but it affects the team more than me. I'll tell you what's wrong before I get off the floor.
Tatia Craiova, 2, Leeds United, 0.
Down to the south coast to see Southampton against Leeds.
Number 4, Jeff Chandler, playing in the attack, is Leeds' recent signing from Blackpool, and it's his first full game in the First Division. Charlie George, what a glorious ball that was to Hebbard. Good cross to Boyer! Has come and Entwistle has scored for Leeds. Chandler saw the opening, created the space with the pass to Entwistle. Geno came off his line and in doing so I think made up Entwistle's mind for him. But the noise being made inside the Dell at the moment is being made by the travelling Leeds supporters. Here's Gray. Oh, through the legs of Williams, and he's got brought down by Peach. It's still a joy to watch this fellow play, Eddie Gray. And there's still nobody who can dribble quite like him, in my opinion. It's an old-fashioned art, but when Gray plays, it's on view. And he finds Curtis. Good run by Alan Curtis. Look at that, he sent them all ways. What a good try. That's an absolutely brilliant goal. That is absolutely outstanding from Curtis. And Leeds are in front. He turned them inside out by himself. And against the run of play, it's all smiles in the Leeds camp. What a good result for Leeds. Dave Merrington walks away at the end of what was a turbulent week for this club. The directors gave the manager a vote of confidence when the fans wanted him out, and it's Leeds' first away win of the season.
Boys, don't cry. Boys, don't cry. I'll break down at your feet and beg forgiveness, plead with you. But I know that it's too late, and now there's nothing I can do. So I try to laugh about it, cover it all up with lies. I try to laugh about it.
How do you feel personally about demonstrations of the type that happened here on Saturday? Does it worry you?
I don't like it, but I've been through it all before. I've been through it at Burnley, I've been through it at Sunderland, going through it a bit here now at Leeds. So it's like water off a duck's back in a lot of cases. I don't like it, but I'm hardened to it.
Discharge your limits, push too, too far.
Less than 15,000 bothered to turn up, and what they saw must have made them wish that they'd stayed at home too. Leeds should have gone ahead after less than a minute, but Paul Hart's header was way off target and the pattern for the night was set. Arthur Graham gave the Romanian defence a few headaches, but by the time the ball got near the goal, the Leeds forwards were showing little imagination. Craiova were even threatening with the odd breakaway. Lucic here keeping the home side in the game. There isn't a lot of luck around at Elland Road these days, unless you count bad luck. Craiova's first goal had plenty of that. Byram Stevenson's half-hearted attempt at clearing the ball had sent his keeper the wrong way, and by now the tie was lost and the Romanian celebrations had started. Soon afterwards, Arthur Graham's shot was the best effort for Leeds of the night, but even that wasn't good enough. There was one spark of inspiration, though, which warmed the crowd. It came at the other end. Beldanu was the scorer, the man who missed a penalty in the first leg. It got the only round of applause of the evening, and it prompted the first sign of protest.
I think it's a disaster for us, but then you've got to get over disasters, haven't you?
What about your own position, Jimmy?
The Leeds directors have not interfered at all. And if they don't interfere with my job and I get on with it and I'm a failure, then I expect to be kicked out the door.
Now tonight's headlines. Leeds manager Jimmy Adamson faces yet another demonstration by angry fans calling for his resignation as his club go out of the UEFA Cup. Leeds chairman Manny Cousins says we're not happy with the present situation and Mr. Adamson will be asked for his policy for the future.